say more about that? We were
going to
come
I'm
back
being
to that.
Provocative
That's
here.
good.
I think because so much research has been done on the middle class, we have forgotten what attachment is for, and we've just whitewashed all the discomfort out and said all of that's bad. Well, if we were a safe species, if our children grew up in safety, and our parents were naturally sensitively responsive, if that just sort of bloomed of its own accord, we wouldn't need attachment. It wouldn't be there in the genome. It's there because life is dangerous and because parents are not always protective. I'll get back to culture in a minute, but this notion that security is our natural state and that parents are inherently sensitive. Parents are busy. I've been one. You were one.
I
we still
one.
Are.
Yeah,
we are. Parents are very busy. They've got to take care of themselves. They've got to take care of their house. They've got to get the food in it. They've got to keep their spouse happy, and that takes effort. And they may have more than one child. From the child's point of view, they're the only person there is. From the parent's point of view, they are not. And parents have to regulate this whole set of demands on them. That means they will not be sensitively available to the child all the time. Children got to tolerate a certain amount of frustration. Mom simply can't be there all the time. It's not possible. Question is, this is a nice little gift from Mary, what does the child need versus what does he want? He wants a whole lot of things. And some of them are needs, and he screams them all the same way. It's the adult who has to decide. This time you want something, and right now your sister needs something. So I'm leaving you wanting and taking care of your sister who needs. And in a very lucky family, all the needs are met. But the families you deal with in treatment, not all the needs are met. They aren't there at the right moment, or there are too many needs and they can only deal with some of them. The culture issue goes back to danger, I would say, that if culture does nothing else, it should pass forward what generations of parents have learned about the danger here, where we live, the safest way to respond to the danger, the best way to predict the danger before it comes so that you can get out of its way. If culture is only the little songs, the dances, the national dress, the food we eat, well, that's very nice and let's all have a party and dress up and eat the food. I think culture is about staying safe here where we live, increasing the probability that our children will survive and that they will have children. And those children will survive. If the danger were the same everywhere, then we wouldn't need cultural differences. But historically it isn't, geographically it isn't. The dangers are different one place to another. And I think our cultures differ in which strategies they use most frequently, because they differ in which dangers they face.